Let's keep it simple. Developed by Doitsujin, DXVK is a project that aims to translate DirectX 9 to 11 into Vulkan API calls. Due to the latter's lower overhead, it may provide better overall performance in single-player-only games. Why not multiplayer? It's not because it doesn't work with them, but because it can get your account banned. Always bearing this in mind, the installation process is really easy. Download dxvk.tar.gz, un7zip.vgz, un7zip.vtar, and copy-paste the correct DLLs beside the GameXE, following this table. Finally, if it was a Steam game, go to Settings, Shader Precaching, and untick it. That's it. All you have to do now is run it, and after a few minutes of stuttering due to shader compilation, enjoy some free FPS. Maybe. To verify such a possibility, I tested 4 games. GTA 4 for DirectX 9 to Vulkan, Crysis for DX9 and 10, Just Cause 2 for DX10, and indeed AC Origins for DX11. First, GTA 4 at max settings and with a couple of tweaks to allocate up to 4GB of RAM and up to 8GB of VRAM, or whatever the amount of memory on your VGA is. Since the integrated benchmark is of doubtful utility, I parked my car at this spot and recorded the frames with RTSS at various times of in-game day. Obviously, the exact same place and hours with both APIs. Well, these are the results. About 7.5 FPS more on the lows and even 25 more on the average. Yes, I'm impressed. Secondly, Crysis 64-bit at max settings, benchmarked with his old but gold tool. Sadly, DXVK didn't work with DX10, but only with DX9. However, as you can notice, it even managed to fix the latter's corrupted water. Here are the results. While the mean FPS are aligned with DX10, the AVG are higher than its max. I'm even more impressed. Thirdly, I chose Just Cause 2, maxed out, because I wanted to test a working translation from DX10 to Vulkan. Although I ran the in-game benchmark on the concrete jungle map, I still recorded the frames with RTSS, as the former doesn't provide enough data. And these are the results. Oh yo yo, a first setback for DXVK. It loses around 20 FPS on the lows and 10 on the average. This proves that DXVK is not a silver bullet, and thus might even reduce performance in some cases. Finally, Assassin's Creed Origins, also at maximum settings, but with the Ubisoft Connect overlay disabled. This is because, with DXVK, the overlay displays an annoying notification that says, "You are running an unsupported video driver. Please update it for optimal performance." Well, you'll see now which API is optimal. Spoiler, not DX11. In fact, Vulkan improves the FPS on all fronts, but especially on the mean, which jump from 15 frames below 60 to 15 frames above 60. Unbelievable! While I show you the data I've collected during my 90 benchmark runs, in case you want them, let's find a simple end to a simple beginning. DXVK can be crazy good. I will definitely try it in each and every DX9, 10 and 11 games I'm gonna play. And I reckon you should as well. Many thanks for tuning in and... farewell for now.